What does a fighter like that go through mentally? When a fighter loses like that, what do they go through?
I don't know that, Belly. It goes a lot of shit in their mind, bro. Because, first of all, she's gonna go take a couple days off, a couple weeks off, maybe a couple months off. And see how much she really wants. If she really wants to keep continuing it. And she's gonna change her routine. She's gonna change her routine. Maybe change her routine. See how she made off the second half. So who knows, you know?
So was she all hype or was she for real or did she just
Ooh. Run
into Ronda? Was she all hype or did she run into like just better fighters?
Nah, I don't think she's hype, bro. I think she was real because she won the Olympics and jiu-jitsu.
And judo.
Yeah. And judo, whatever. You know, she's not hype, but she just...
Huh? Yeah.
She probably never got that shit out of her mind after the Holly Holmes, whatever. But who knows? But at the end of the day, like I said, I don't give a fuck because I'm not a UFC fan. I don't watch all the fights. I don't know shit about UFC. All I heard, I watch fights and they say it's gonna be a good fight. So I order it and I watch it. That's all I do. So if you guys need anything about UFC, I don't know what the fuck is going on.
Damn. But that means it's a big sport too. Like boxing, big fights attract a lot of attention. Just like when you guys have big fights, a lot of people watch too.
Not really, not a lot of people watch.
Like when Floyd will fight Pacquiao, a lot of people watch.
Oh, a lot of people watch that fight, yeah. So it depends on what kind of fight you're talking about. So you get somebody talking about like somebody fighting a fucking like this guy, they all, oh, man, these guys are good. You think people are gonna watch? No. But if it's just on Telefutura or something like that, nobody's gonna watch. You know, they gotta get recognized by like by the big networks and shit like that, just that people get attention and shit.
But like Euro Victor's fight, if somebody even doesn't watch boxing, if they watch the build-up and the history,
homie. Is the bell rung?
People are gonna want to see that.
Huh?
Like you and Victor, people even if you don't know boxing, they know the history of what you're going through, they're gonna wanna see that.
But in reality, people that are watching it is because they're mostly boxing fans. You know what I mean? And they know the history, that's why they watch it, because they know they're boxing fans. But like if you tell me about, honestly, about Nate Diaz and Conor McGregor, I know the history about it or nothing like that. I don't know what the build up is. The reason why I watch it is because I heard it's gonna be a good fight, and that's why I watched it. And then I like the way Nate Diaz answered because they say he's like me, so that's why. So that's why I started watching Nate Diaz that fight. Honestly, I know Nate Diaz before this fight. You know, I really don't follow UFC. And nothing against the people, yeah. Nothing against nobody from the UFC. I just don't watch UFC. But they never talk about that. I would never watch it, but they watched it. And I'm glad I got sick, and now I got to meet Nate Diaz. He's a cool motherfucker.
You don't know? Well, you don't get in. What's the password? Huh? You let me know and I'll let you in.
There it is.
Next time you gotta say, fuck you.
Asshole.
Man, that's all you gotta say, motherfucker. Change
it. All right.
Hey, present! Yay!
7, 8, 9, 10.
No, how old is he? He get in right now. He's good.
Yeah, that's fine.
Come here. Check it out. Come. I thought when I was 8.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. And you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback. Thank you.